Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to remove work or school account from your Windows 11 operating system. So let's get started. So currently I am on a Windows 11 system and at the login screen, and here you can see that I had two different accounts. One is the personal account, which is actually a Microsoft account, and second one is the account connected to Azure AD, and this is the work or school account. So first I will try to remove the work or school account using my personal account. So I will just sign into my personal account first. Then I will right click on the start button and select settings. In the settings app, I will go to accounts. Under accounts, I will click on access work or school. Inside access work or school, you can see that I have the account connected to Azure AD listed here, and the account is connected to Kapila.com's Azure AD. When you expand this account, you can see the disconnect this account, and there is a disconnect button here. When we click the disconnect button, you can see that there is a pop-up. Are you sure you want to remove this account? This will remove your access to resources like email, apps, network, and all content associated with it. Your organization might also remove some data stored on this device. So as soon as you click yes on this flyout menu, then your work or school account will be immediately removed from your Windows 11 operating system. So this is one method, and it is the easiest method. Now the question is, what you will do if you have the single account on your system, which is work or school account? So let us see what steps you have to try in that case. So first we will sign into that work or school account. So here we are now signed into work or school account. Now we will right click on the start button and select settings. When the settings app opens, go to accounts. Then go to access work or school. Here you can see that the Azure AD or work or school account is listed here. Again, we have here disconnect button. We will now click on the disconnect button here, and we have the same pop-up, so click yes in that. We are assuming these steps in case if you have the only work or school account on your system. In the disconnect from the organization window, you can see that after disconnecting, you won't be able to sign into this PC with your organization's account. If this PC has BitLocker installed and running, make sure you save a copy of BitLocker recovery key somewhere other than this PC. When you confirm all of this information, you have to hit the disconnect button. Then you will be asked to enter alternate account information. To make sure that you can sign into this PC after disconnecting from organization, enter the sign-in info for a local administrator account. This can be a Microsoft account or local account. So in this case, you have to just type in the information for the alternate account you have on this system so that you can sign in and do not get logged out after removing the work or school account. If you do not have any other account on this system, you can leave this part and create that account first, and after that, try disconnecting from the organization. So here we have filled up the information for other account, and here you can see that restart your PC. After restarting, your PC won't be joined to the Kapila.com Azure AD account. You will need to sign in with the another user account you provided information in the previous page. So simply click on the restart now button there, and then click on restart anyway if the pop-up appears. After this, your system will restart. And once it restarts, your system will be completely disconnected from your work or school account. So after restarting the system, we are again back to the lock screen, and then we will pull it up so that we can access the login screen. And in the login screen, you can see that the only account now I have on the system is the personal account. And I will sign into it To reconfirm that the work or school account has been completely removed from this system, I will just again right click on the start button and select settings. In the settings app, we will go to accounts and this time email and accounts. Earlier we have all the accounts listed here, but here now we have only the personal account listed. That means the work or school account has been removed. Again, we will go to access work or school, and here we can see that the Azure AD or work or school account has been completely removed. So that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.